Good morning. I am Sri Priya, Assistant Professor, Department of CSE from Pratyusha Engineering College. Now we are going to see about the UML. What is the UML? Then the types of the UML. Then the UML diagrams in which we will draw. So first, what is a UML? UML stands for the Unified Modeling Language. Actually, it is an artifact for the system. Artifact is nothing but the development of the product for the software. They are also used for the specifying, constructing and visualizing the artifacts of the software systems. They actually provides and simplifies the complex job done by the software system. Our software system are all, they are also called as the project. So in a project we are having a number of modules. They simplifies, the model simplifies the complexity of the project. Likewise here in the UML, it divides and the complexity of the system will be reduced in the UML diagrams. So these are the type of diagrams. First is the use case diagram, class diagram, sequence, collaboration and state diagram, which we are going to see. So apart from this, there is an activity diagram and deployment diagram that is also available. But we will mostly concentrate on these five things for the UML. First is the use case. Here in the use case, it is described as a set of scenarios. Scenarios can be anything. Here and the example can be a classroom scenario or it may be a library scenario in which the actors as well as the actions which has happened in the system. We will use the use case diagram mainly for getting the requirements from the user. There is here we will mention it as a actors. It is a contact between the end user as well as the system. Now the actors. It is a role that is played to the respect of the system. It includes the humans, our systems, or maybe a database. Example here, we are seeing the example as a robo, not only the robo. It may be a database, or a cashier, or account, or a teacher, or anything they will call as actors. There are two types of actors. One is the primary actor, the second is the supporting actors. Here they mention the actor symbol. This is an actor. Then the use case, which the actions can be represented. In the use case, nothing but a set of scenarios which we already seen. It is an interaction between the user as well as the system. The association. The association between the association can be used only in the class diagram, and in the use cases, it is represented by a solid line. And the generalization, in case of the parent-child relationship, you will use this symbol, triangular arrow symbol, you will use for the generalization relationship. Here we are going to see about the library system. It is the boundary between the, that is the use case as well as the actor. Here what are the use cases that are happening here, what are the actions are borrowing done by the employee as well as the client. He will order the title also. The employee which he wants to borrow the book, he will get it from the order title. Then find the number by the client. This is the sample use case for the library system. Then next, it is for the clinical use case diagram. There it is an actor, patient, he is one of the actor, scheduler, doctor, clerk, they are all the actors. Then what are their works and what are their actions that was performed by these people, or the patient will cancel the appointment or make the appointment. Here we are using the three set of relationship. One is the include, extend and generalization relationship. Include is for the compulsory actions. So see, if you are in the make appointment, the patient should pay or check the patient record, and he has to pay for the particular appointment. Extend is that is not a compulsory, that may be an optional one. Here the deferred payment, that may be more extra. If he is paying extra 3 months, he has to pay the bill for that. There is an extent generalization, as we already know, that is for the specialized parent-child relationship. We will use the third one, that is the generalization relationship. Then next is the class diagram. It provides the structure of the behavioral as well as the use cases. There is a set example. We can take the class diagram. The accountant, when we see the accountant as a class name, he is having some attributes as well as the operations that are performed by the particular accountant. There may be a number of entities that can be included in the class diagram. Here in each class, it is represented by a rectangle and it is divided into these three. modules in which the class name is related to, and the third is the operations. Here the modifiers which we are using, the default is the public one. The plus symbol we use for the public visibility, and the hash is for the protected one, and the minus symbol is for the private visibility. See, in this example, account name, that is the name of the class given here. The second part will be the attributes, in which the name of the customer name as well as the balance of the account and name was paid. Then the third compartment will be your operations, in which he can add or withdraw, he can inquire for the balance. That is the third part for the operations. This is the total structure of the class diagram. Then suppose we will be your class name, then second will be your attributes, the third will be the operations. There are two kinds of relationships. One is the generalization association relationship. As we already said, apart from there will be two sets. One is the aggregation and composition. Aggregation is the has a relationship, there is an association, and the composition will be restricted part of the association. It is an example for the sequence diagram. This the caller, phone, and recipient will be the software objects. Here these are the messages which they will connected will be in the caller as well as the phone. This is an example for the pick the phone call. This is the object lifelines. Object lifelines. Here the A created the B object. This is the software objects in which this rectangle shape is called as the lifespan. In which the A create the B objects. The return type will be the dotted line that represents the return one. The cross symbol that represents the deletion of the particular object line. It is a collaboration diagram, as these rectangles represent the software objects. The arrows as well as the sequence number, they gives the flow of the directions of the messages. Next is the state diagram. It represents the sequence of the actions done by the object throughout the life cycle. Here the example is whether the payment is paid or not. There will be some starting point, there is some notations was represented for this starting as well as for the ending. These paid and unpaid, they are the states. Here one more example is given for the traffic light. Here red, yellow and green. These three are the states. In this, the event that was done here is the cause sensor. Cause sensor is the event, and the transition between the red to green, that is called as a transition. That is the diagram that is called as a transition. Okay.